Is it me?
Go.
Silverchair here on Alternative Nation on the way. I've already read this.
You're doing it again.
Oh, you're so dumb. Rufus Lotus.
Oh. Okay.
Go.
Take two.
Well, we got together when we were about 12, and we're jamming and stuff. Yeah, you know, just jamming, and it wasn't anything really serious.
I was just playing a guitar at Ben's house, the drummer, and I was just playing some songs that really, and I was just mucking around playing the guitar, and he got on the drums, and we just started jamming, just for something to do, because we were really bored, and after a while we got a little bit better, but it still sounded really shit because we didn't have a bass player.
Daniel asked me if I wanted to play bass in the band, and I thought, why not, and Ben had bought a bass, so I just bought that one off him and started playing it.
First, we started off because I just started learning guitar. We're into like Led Zeppelin and stuff, and Deep Purple and stuff. But I couldn't play any of their songs because I was too bad. So we just played Hound Dog by Elvis. because that's all we could play. Then after a while, we started playing some Deep Purple and Led Zeppelin songs just by ourselves.
We only practice about maybe once or twice a week. It wasn't like mega full on, but we all just really like what we were doing. Yeah.
Okay.
And we were good friends as well.
And we started getting a few gigs, and we were pretty shocked by that. Because we're really shit. Yeah, then we entered a demo competition after a while because we recorded a demo. Wasn't very good, but anyway. And they called us back after a while and said that we'd won. So we were really stoked about that. And, so we won and did a film clip and recorded Tomorrow.
That was probably one of the first decent songs that we wrote for us, yeah, and there's nothing much to tell about it. You know, we just sat in a room and wrote it, and that was it, and we just started playing it.
It's 12 o'clock and it's a wonderful day. The only way to get there's to go straight down. There's no bathroom and there is no safe. The water out of the tap is very we
but I'd like to still live without it. You think you can keep on going, living like a king? Ooh, babe, I strongly doubt it.
One time we were all staying at Ben's house and we were really bored, so he said, oh, we'll request a song on the radio. We'll request Berlin Chair by UMI. And that day at school we were talking about how we don't like Nirvana very much to some of our friends, and they said, oh, you should listen to Sliver because it's a good song. And we said, Chris, I'll write down Sliver and Chair, like Sliver Chair, just to abbreviate it so I remembered what songs we wanted to request. And he spelled it Silverchair. So he said, oh, good one. At the start, we really liked Pearl Jam. They were a real big influence at the start, but then after a while, we kind of said, nah, I'm not into that anymore.
Now I think we've moved on a bit and got a bit heavier and changed a bit, yeah.
Most of the later stuff, like some of the songs on the album, like Undecided or Mad Men or some of the other songs, they're influenced by Helmet and Soundgarden probably. Particularly like the comparisons to Nirvana, because we think that, you know, the music's nothing like them.
Just a lot of people say, oh, you're trying to be Nirvana, because we're a three-piece and I've got blonde hair, but once my hair gets down to about there and I get dreadlocks and stuff like that, they won't say it. It's just because the hair is that long and I'm trying to grow, but it won't grow. So I'm just going to keep trying to grow it, and if it doesn't grow, I'll just shave my head and be a punk.
People dying for no reason at all.
Thank you.
some dude in the crowd decided it'd be pretty fun to make a guy's head bleed. Pegged a bottle at my head. It was pretty good, it was fun. There would have been some good pictures, but Mum's camera got stolen. I've always thought that we get a better sound live, it's just more energetic live and stuff. We seem to play a lot of our songs a lot faster live and stuff, and it's just good to see a good mosh pit and stuff.
Playing to that amount of people gave you a really big buzz, but I still prefer playing to a smaller audience. You can leave me out. Leave me out. Leave me out. Oh, yeah. It was just good publicity to play with the Chili Peppers. And they asked us, so we just said yeah. Thought they were good. I really, Flea was a bit of a psycho. The first show that I watched, he like pulled his pants down and his butt was hanging out, so that was pretty funny.
Seriously about, they say, oh, they won't be able to play live, it's just an act and stuff like that. But I think it's like Milli Vanilli.
Everyone says it's a job, but I don't really see it as a job. I see it as playing music, having fun. I don't know. people say the novelty wears off, but it hasn't yet. I don't think so. It's always a good buzz to see the people appreciate something that you're doing. Well, hoping that everything goes well and the band just doesn't blow out within 6 months or something.